This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Huron Civic Arena, the site for the 2014 Girls Speed Basketball Tournament. 12 games over the next 3 days here on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. I'm Steve Toome along with J.J. Hartigan. 4 games coming your way today here from the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament. We'll start off with Sully Buttes against Gayville Volin. Follow that up with Warner, the defending champions, taking on Lemon. Our night session tonight will be Hanson against Lyman, and then it's Sanborn Central Woonsocket against Kimball White Lake. That's the first round pairings here for the B tournament. J.J. Hartigan, you got the defending champions back, number 2 in the poll, but the number 4 seed and number 1 Sully Buttes. They've been impressive.
Yeah, for that Warner team, obviously they're a volleyball team, back-to-back champions. They're trying to do that again in basketball. There's no team at the B level who's ever done it in volleyball and in basketball, so hoping for some history here tonight, or this weekend, I should say, for that Warner club. But obviously, this is going to be an exciting matchup today between Sully Buttes and Gayville Volin as we get underway here today. And already a raucous crowd here inside the Huron Arena. The pep band from Bridgewater, Emery Ethan, brought 135 kids in their band alone today. They were blowing us away earlier on today, and it's looking like we're going to have an exciting afternoon of basketball here in our first session.
You see the Raiders of Gayville Volin warming up. They've never been to the state tournament before. They had to go to overtime to beat Freeman in the region finals, and they brought a pretty good crowd here. There you see the Raiders. First-year coach Matt Malloy, a Parkston native. Of course, a great basketball player. They're there for the Trojans as they went 15-7 on the season, getting into the state tournament. They had to win 3 games in their district in order to qualify. And then again, that exciting win in Yankton against the Freeman Flyers in overtime. Here's the starting lineup for the Raiders.
Yeah, you look at Rachel Haas there, the 5'7 senior. She's one of 2 seniors, rather, for this Raiders club coming into Huron. Vanessa Reichen, also a 5'6 senior, playing at the forward position. Then you get the 3 guards there. Kayla Barda, who's a 5'7 junior. Jenny Clark, the 5'6 sophomore. And Lauren Nelson, the 5'6 freshman. They're going with 3 guards. Matt Malloy was a great guard at USF playing there, was one of the best players ever to come from the Cougars program there in Sioux Falls. He's taking his knowledge and, of course, his basketball skill set now as a coach and hoping that he can take this Gayville Volin team a long ways here. They were called Cinderellas in those regionals, but he didn't like that. He was kind of hoping that people would give them a little bit more credit, but he's embraced that Cinderella role, and this could be a team in the 8th seed that might surprise some people here at this tournament in Huron.
Roland Johnson, the assistant coach, a longtime coach at Plainview, Nebraska. Now let's meet the Chargers of Sully Buttes. For the 9th time in the last 11 years, the Chargers are back in the state tournament. Mark Zeffner's got that program rolling 21-1. Their only loss came at the hands of DeSmet down at the Corn Palace back on January the 18th, 34-28. The score in that game, their lineup is explosive. Not only are they great offensively, but defensively, the starting lineup for the Chargers: Carly Stahl, Deidre Lamb, Kayla Nelson, Chloe Lamb, Remy Wenches, some familiar names there. Of course, the Lambs are cousins, and they've been related to some of the other great Lamb players that have come through that program. Sully Buttes averages 65.5 points a game. They only give up a little over 30, so their average margin of victory, 35 points. They shoot 67% from the free throw line. It will be important today for the Raiders to stay close to this powerhouse team. We're just moments away from the introduction of the starting lineup. Josh Hader, he is our public address announcer. In a moment, we'll turn it over to him, and we'll have our pregame festivities underway here
on SDPB3 South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Good afternoon. The South Dakota High Schools Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, welcome you to this opening session of the State Girls High School Basketball Tournament. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of the high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you will enjoy the games and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Be a sport and support good sportsmanship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand to honor America and join in the singing of our national anthem as it is played by the Bridgewater Emory Husky Band under the direction of Dan Clark. We would remind all in attendance that proper respect is to remove your cap or hat, face the flag, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag. And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Huron Arena for this first game of state basketball tournament action between the Gayville Volin Raiders and the Sully Buttes Chargers. Let's first meet the Raiders cheerleaders. Shanoa Banks, Lexi Ellison, Jamie Hoffman, Marin Buffington, Hannah Rolfs, and Rochelle Smith. The Raiders cheerleaders are coached by Rebecca Miller. And now let's meet the Gayville Volin non-starters. Number 20, Viola Ishmael. Number 21, Megan Hirsch. Number 23, Grace Dangle. Number 24, Tara Dotti. Number 31, Daniela Jensen. Number 33, Samantha Williams. Number 34, Addison Bertrand. And number 43, Treya Hubbard. The assistant coach is Ronald Johnson. Head coach, Matt Malloy. And now let's meet the non-starters for the Sully Buttes Chargers. Number 5, Olivia Rausch. Number 10, Bailey Bradford. Number 14, Audrey Johnson. Number 15, Jerrica Menninger. Number 20, Hannah Weinheimer. Number 21, Raquel Wenges. Number 23, Aaron Foth. Number 24, Mindy Raveness. Number 32, Kristen Seek. And number 40, Rachel Guth Miller. And now let's meet the starters for today's game. At guard for the Raiders, number 10, Jenny Clark. At guard for the Chargers, number 1, Kayla Nelson. At forward for the Raiders, number 11, Rachel Haas. At guard for the Chargers, number 3, Remy Winches. At forward for the Raiders, number 12, Vanessa Riken. At forward for the Chargers, number 12, Deidre Lamb. At guard for the Raiders, number 14, Laura Nelson. At guard for the Chargers, number 22, Chloe Lamb. At guard for the Raiders, number 15, Kalia Barton. At forward for the Chargers, number 31, Carly Stahl. The officials for today's game are Randy Klute, Scott Hookey, Brett Seether, and Bill Shanefish.
All right, we're ready for basketball here from the Class B tournament in Huron. I'm Steve Toome along with J.J. Hartigan, the voice of SDSU women's basketball, who hopefully will be finding out where they play in the postseason. We know they're going to be going somewhere in the postseason, whether or not it's in the NCAA or the women's NIT yet to be determined.
Yeah, South Dakota State has at least guaranteed themselves a WNIT bid after winning the regular season conference title. There's still a chance they could get into that NCAA tournament, but as of last look on the bracketology side of things, it looks like they're one of the last five teams out, unfortunately. So we're going to have to wait and see. You never know. They might sneak their way into that NCAA tournament. Otherwise, WNIT bound, and South Dakota State hoping that they'll be able to do some good things. There have been a lot of great players from South Dakota who've gone on to play Division I college basketball, both at SDSU, USD, and beyond. So hopefully we'll see some hidden gems here this weekend as well.
Chargers are in white. They control the tap, and that'll be Chloe Lamb. Zone defense here for the Raiders. 2-3 to start off. The Chargers keep it around the perimeter. Here's a three on the way. Short, long rebound, goes out of bounds. Remy Wenches misfires, and the Raiders hold on their first defensive possession. And here comes that pressure defense Sully Buttes is famous for employing. They want to force turnovers and get some layups on the other end. Gayville Volin cautiously bringing it up with Laura Nelson. Hands off there to Kalea Barta. Near steal there, and there is a steal by Nelson. 2-0.
To Kayla Nelson.
Chargers forced the turnover in the half-court defense. Raiders bringing it up quickly with Barta. Jenny Clark. Laura Nelson, great cross-country runners. They were 1-2 in the state. Clark won it last year, second this year. Nelson won it for the Raiders. Near steal there as Clark handles. Can't get the shot away. Now over to Nelson. Here's a three on the way, short. Rebound tip, but controlled by Chloe Lamb. Here comes Stahl up the court. She's got over 1,000 points. Near steal, but controlled there by Wenches. Now the Raiders settle back in that 2-3 zone. Wenches on the perimeter, averages 16 a game. Down low here, Stahl, the turnaround, it's short. Gets her own rebound, puts it up and is fouled. Two free throws coming up here. And that foul will be on Vanessa Riken, one of the senior leaders for the Raiders. Six-16 left, first quarter just underway. Free throw up and good by Stahl, who averages 10.5 points a game. Sub in, that's Megan Hirsch for the Raiders. She'll replace Vanessa Riken. Got them both, 4-0, Chargers out early. Barta and Nelson bring the ball up cautiously. 10 count.
Sully Buttes with great full court pressure here, and there it is, the 10 count right away. The defensive pressure came in as soon as the ball was inbounded. They kind of backed up towards the half court line and then put pressure on again with the ball carrier getting near that half court line. Nothing they could really do but just try to work their way around it there. And you could see Matt Malloy a little frustrated with the way that they brought up the ball there that last time around.
Yeah, they took too much time, and that's kind of an error you cannot make against a team like Sully Buttes. Mind you, the Chargers want to force that kind of play, forcing that kind of mistake. But you got to be a little wiser with the clock as Stahl gets it inside, can't make the shot, and there's Hirsch with the rebound. Sparta brings it up. Man-to-man for Sully Buttes on defense. Pass off into the corner to Nelson. Haas straight away gives way to Barta. Back to Haas through her fingers, but quick picks it back up. Puts up the jumper. No good. The long rebound pulled down by Deidre Lamb.
Sully Buttes looking a little tentative here at the early goings, just trying to get a feel for the state tournament. Maybe just get their legs underneath them more than anything else as a foul is called underneath.
Stahl will have some more free throws. Great entry pass to set it up there for the Chargers. They knew exactly what they wanted. And that foul will be on Jenny Clark. That's her first, team second. Stahl back at the line, 5'9 senior. 10.5 points, 8 rebounds per game.
Sully Buttes just 1 of 5 to start the game from the floor, but this is already their second trip to the free throw line. They're getting the ball inside. They're creating contact inside the lane there. You could see them be going to the line quite a bit here in the first half if the Raiders don't settle down defensively.
Raquel Winches in, replaces Deidre Lamb for the Chargers, and Stahl missed them both. Break there for the Raiders. Let's see if they can capitalize. They have yet to score. Nelson up top. Clark and Haas and Barta are their main scoring threats for the Raiders. All average double figures. Pass inside, tipped away, and out of bounds. And the ball will stay with the Raiders. We've got a break. You're watching the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the Huron Civic Arena Class B Girls Basketball Tournament here on SDPB3. Steve Toome with you. J.J. Hartigan along as well. Raiders wearing the dark uniforms playing in. Sully Buttes staying in that man-to-man. Drive by Clark, the shot blocked. Hirsch pulls it down. Sully Buttes wants to run, but the Raiders get back on defense. Open top of the key is the shooter for the Chargers. High arcing three is an air ball, but it's saved. On the miss there was Chloe Lamb. The Raiders end up with it. Drive by Clark, shut down. And a whistle along the baseline. Rachel Haas getting set to check in here. That foul will be on Chloe Lamb. That's her first, team's first. Haas in, she'll replace Vanessa Ryken. The Raiders play it in, no shot from the corner. Barta handles now. Gives way there to Clark, down the lane, the shot up off the window is good. The Raiders on the scoreboard.
Nice little crossover there at the free throw line. She had originally started to her right, switched and went to her left there with the left-handed dribble, found an opening inside the lane and got the first bucket. That's gotta be a weight off their shoulders now. 1 of 4 from the floor today for the Raiders.
There's the open shooter, that's Winches. Three ball there for her, Remy Winches. 16 points, 5 rebounds a game is what that senior averages. Clark gets it in the front court. Steps around the defender and is fouled. There you see the speed of Jenny Clark. Again, the cross-country champion from a year ago, second place this year. That foul will be on Raquel Winches. That is her first, team
well,
second.
For Clark there, that was actually a smart move. She got caught underneath the hoop on the right side of the paint, and instead of just taking the foul and having to inbound it underneath the hoop, she kind of went up in the air at the last second. The officials noticed it. She never really attempted a shot, but they said she was in the act of shooting, and So a couple free throws coming your way.
Kayla Nelson out. Deidre Lamb checks in for the Chargers.
I think we call that selling it.
Yes. And the free throws are both good by Clark. The sophomore has all 4 points for the Raiders. So they fall back into that 2-3 zone.
You could tell early on the Raiders were a little nervous coming into this one, but they've seen this after that first media timeout, gotten their legs back underneath them and are playing a little bit better, although the foul called there.
Stahl again working into the paint and draws a foul for the third time. And that's going to be on Rachel Haas, her first, team's third. Matt Malloy happy with the defense there.
This already the third trip to the free throw line for Sully Buttes.
But Stahl has missed three free throws in a row, a sub in. That's Vanessa Reichen to replace Rachel Haas.
Yeah, as a team now, they're just 2 of 5 from the free throw line.
Yep, and all those free throws attempted by Carly Stahl, the 5'9 senior. Missed that one. Rebound pulled down by Megan Hirsch. Barta brings the ball up. Sully Buttes, man-to-man. Here's an open shooter, the high arcing three, bingo! Jenny Clark! And we're tied at 7.
Clark looked back at her coach, Matt Malloy, there a moment ago and reached down at her left ankle. We'll have to see how she plays here, but she's a little hesitant on that foot right now.
Here's a three on the way, it's good. Winches now with 6, the answer for the Chargers. You wonder if Clark may have landed wrong on that ankle. She is favoring it a bit. She'll get the pass here, fakes the three. The jumper gonna be short. Rebound pulled down by Stahl. Nothing there for the Chargers on a fast break opportunity. Raiders got back on defense. I'm sure that's one thing Coach Malloy and assistant coach Johnson drilled into this team, make sure you get back. Here's the free throw line jumper, and it's good. That was Raquel Winches. She averages 9 points, a 5'8 freshman. And the lead is 12-7. A little bit of pressure. Here comes the shot from the corner. It's gonna be good, and it's a three. That's Laura Nelson. Timeout called by Sully Buttes. 1:38 left. 12-10. Sully Buttes on top. Get you an update here from the AA tournament. Washington leads Harrisburg 10-4 at the moment. The A tournament yet to start. That's happening out in Spearfish.
Well, Steve, for the first time ever, the host of public radio's smash hit This American Life is coming to South Dakota. Ira Glass will appear live at the Washington Pavilion Saturday, April 5th at 7:30 p.m. He'll share the story of how his program revolutionized radio and spawned a new generation of storytellers. Tickets are on sale now online at the Washington Pavilion website. That's washingtonpavilion.org. All proceeds will benefit Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Such a contrast here. The one seed Sully Buttes, 9 trips in the last 11 years to the State B. Gayville Volin, the 8 seed, never been here before.
Yeah, and as Matt Malloy told us yesterday during shoot around, he doesn't necessarily like the name tag Cinderella, but the team is embracing it and saying, hey, if that's what everybody wants us to be, we'll do it. We'll go out, we'll impress, we'll put on a show and see if we can't get that Cinderella story for the state of South Dakota.
Counted in the foul. What a move along the baseline. That's Remy Wench's nifty move, and she'll collect that foul on Kalia Barta. The junior picks up her first, team's 4th for the Raiders.
And that was a play they worked on during their shoot-around extensively yesterday, trying to make sure that they played solid defense inside. They knew that the ball was going to be going in more often than not for this Sully Buttes Chargers team. They just have to play good defense, and the Raiders are going to be able to stay in this game.
Barta collects the rebound there. 1:20 and counting. 14-10 Chargers. Barta will call out a play. Put it in motion with Nelson. She'll drive, shut off. Here's the three ball on the way. It's going to be short. The long rebound pulled down by Raquel Winches. Here's the free throw line jumper. No. And the rebound pulled down, and we have a foul on the Raiders. It's going to be the fifth team foul, and that one's going to be on Megan Hirsch, her first, team's fifth. Viola Ishmael, number 20, checks in. She'll replace Clark, definitely limping over to the bench. Noticeable limp in her step. Here's the inbounds pass to Stahl. She'll take it, get open, and score. 4 points for Carly Stahl. Under a minute to go.
And we should point out that Jenny Clark for Gayville Volin is on the sideline right now being checked out by the training staff. We mentioned her ankle earlier. That would be a huge loss for this team.
Hopefully that young lady can return. Here's a drive by Nelson shut off. Barta on the drive, can't get to the baseline. Ryken lost the handle, pulled down out of the air by Deidre Lamb. 22 seconds, Chargers want to run in the paint. Collision, no foul, and Ishmael picks up the loose ball. 13 seconds and counting. Let's see what the Raiders can do in the final possession here of the first quarter. Hirsch to the corner, Ryken, no good. We're done with one period of play. 16-10, Chargers lead the Raiders. You're watching the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We are back in Huron at the Civic Arena, getting ready for the start of the second quarter of play. It's Sully Buttes leading Gayville Volin 16-10. 8 points for Remy Wenches leading the way for the Chargers. 7 for Jenny Clark, top scorer for the Raiders. Clark is on the bench, her ankle being checked out by the training staff. Raiders start the period with the basketball. Near travel there by Ryken, but she got the ball away to Barta. Here's a drive, Haas shut off outside, the fake by Ryken. Down low, pass tipped away and stolen by Raquel Wenches. Hands off to Lamb. Deidre Lamb passes ahead. Wenches has hit a couple of threes. Olivia Roush into the game. The drive, no shot there. Here's a free throw line jumper, rolls around, no good for Lamb. Rebound fought for, and we've got a whistle. And that foul is going to be on the Raiders. That's on Vanessa Ryken. That's her second. Subs in for the Chargers. Chloe Lamb checking in. She'll replace Remy Wenches. And quickly to the scores table for the Raiders. Here comes Viola Ishmael. And she's going to replace Ryken, who's got to check out with two fouls. Sully Buttes plays it in. Deidre Lamb. They'll throw it out top, and there is Kayla Nelson, who's back into the game. They lob it down low. Stahl got a step, puts it up off the window. Nice move in the paint by Carly Stahl. And the lead is 8 for the Chargers. Here's a drive and a foul and a layup attempt by Rachel Haas. She'll go to the free throw line. Took it right down the court. And that foul will be on Deidre Lamb, the 5'9 sophomore, collects her first. Team's third. Free throw on the way is good, and Rachel Haas into the scoring column. Jenny Clark's going to check in here. That's a good sign for the Raiders if this free throw is good, and it is. And Ishmael will check out. And the 5'6 sophomore, Jenny Clark, back into the game. Clark averages 11.5 points and just over 3 rebounds a game. She'll be working the baseline on that 2-3 zone as the Chargers bring it up. Chloe Lamb directing traffic there. Gets it over to Nelson. Top, here's Raquel Wenches. Down low, Stahl again, gets an angle, can't make it, tipped once, but right in the hands of Laura Nelson. Got a Nelson on the court for both teams. Laura for the Raiders, Kayla for the Chargers. There's a pass, tipped out of bounds. A little miscommunication there. It'll go to Sully Buttes.
Yeah, I think Nelson thought that Jenny Clark was going to cut baseline and go towards the hoop. The pass was kind of angled that way. Instead, Clark stepped back into the corner. Nothing she could do there but just watch it go out of bounds. And the Raiders still within a two-point or a two-possession game here right now. Still plenty of time in this first half. Not really any need for urgency at this point.
No, I think the pace of the game really has favored the Raiders. As Stahl plays a little inside-outside game here. Here's a drive. The jumper up and good. That's Chloe Lamb with her first points. Raiders have some people who can run, no doubt about it, but when it comes to the game of basketball, I think they don't want to get into a track meet with Sully Butte. Sully Butte's, they can run all day as well. Here's a shot, no good, put up there by Barda, the rebound to the Chargers. They're up by eight. Remy Wench's handles up top. Now inside, and we're going to have a jump ball. Possession arrow favors Sully Buttes. Nice defense by the Raiders. And the Chargers will play it in from the baseline with Remy Wenches. They lob it inside, but it's stolen away by Hirsch. Again, good defense by the Raiders. Here's Clark racing down court. Can't get to the baseline. Open jumper. That's Haas. No good. The long rebound tip to Clark. Got the jumper. It's an air ball, and it's pulled out of the air by Chloe Lamb. But she lost it. Picks it back up. Sully Buttes will run the offense. Free throw line jumper. No good. Ball tipped once, but right to Kayla Nelson, who scores. She's got four. Coming up on the 5-minute mark here, and the lead is now 10 for the Chargers. Raiders pass it around the perimeter. Clark fakes, and we'll have a foul, and that's a blocking foul. And that's going to be on Chloe Lamb. Timeout on the court. You're watching the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament here on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We're back at the Huron Civic Arena. Steve Toome and J.J. Hartigan. This is the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament. First game of the day. Sully Buttes leading Gayville Volin. 14 fouls on Sully Buttes, 6 on the Raiders. So we're in period number 2. High post is Ryken. She'll put up the jumper, and it's short. But the pass, or the, rather the rebound pulled out of the air by the Raiders. Stick back, no good. That's Jenny Clark going to the line. Foul on Sully Buttes will be the fifth team foul. And that is going to be on Kayla Nelson, her first.
Clark's already 2 of 2 from the free throw line today. Gayville Volin hasn't missed at the stripe yet. And we just jinxed him. But Sully Buttes just 2 of 7 from the free throw line. If the Raiders can win that battle at the free throw line, they should be able to stay in this game. It's kind of getting away from them here in the second quarter, down by 10 now all of a sudden. They need some points and a little momentum back on their side.
Clark got that one. She's 3 of 4 at the line. 8 points in the game to lead the way for the Raiders so far. They're down by 9. Chargers showing a lot of patience. They're looking for Stahl. She's not open, so they'll swing it around to Chloe Lamb. Now here's Stahl with the high post. Good ball movement and traveling. Turnover, Sully Buttes. Update from the AA tournament. Sioux Falls, Washington out in front of Harrisburg, 26-16, about halfway through the second quarter. Harrisburg, the defending Class A champions, they move up to AA this year, along with Spearfish. They were Class A last year. They made the tournament in the AA ranks. Oh, near turnover. Clark somehow got in the front court. Here's a drive. Nice pass by Ryken, and there's Haas to finish it. She's got 4. What a pass by Ryken.
Great recognition to realize where her teammate was. Drew the defender inside the lane. Nifty bounce pass to finish off the play.
They lob it down low. Chloe Lamb, the fadeaway, no good, and Haas pulls down the rebound. 7-point edge for the Chargers. As Barta handles out front, here's a drive by Haas, puts it up, and it's blocked. And Chloe Lamb brings it the other way for Sully Buttes. Chargers want to run, lost the handle. Collision, players hitting the deck left and right. It's a scramble, but Sully Buttes ends up with it. Wenches off the window, no good, and Haas pulls down another rebound. Wild play there. Chargers can't score, they got a good look. The Raiders come away with the basketball. Nelson can't fire the three, gives way to Clark. And she'll fire the three, and it's going to be off the mark. High arcing shot pulled down by Deidre Lamb. Near steal at half court. Here comes a drive by Wenches. The spin move, the finish. No, but she draws the foul and will get two free throws. And that foul is on Jenny Clark, and that is her second. Team seventh, but this was in the act of shooting. Clark is going to be coming out here in a moment, one would suspect. Wenches at the line, 0 of 1 on the day. Got that one, give her 9 points. Raquel Wenches in, Chloe Lamb out for the Chargers. Viola Ishmael in for the Raiders. Jenny Clark will take a seat on the bench. Second one on the way is going to be short, but she follows her own shot, and Sully Buttes has a chance to score. Nice hustle there by Wenches. She'll direct traffic, high post. Deidre Lamb, Raquel Wenches, steps through, missed it. Rebound, stall, put it up, and draws the foul. Another offensive rebound there for Sully Buttes. And that's going to be on Rachel Haas. That's her second foul. So now you have Clark, Haas, and Reichen, three of the main players for the Raiders, each with two fouls. We still got nearly 2.5 minutes left to go until halftime. Stahl connects on that one. She had missed four in a row. And a timeout has been called by Gayville Volin. 2:27 left, 24-15. Chargers on top of the Raiders.
SDPB TV recorded the state high school gymnastics competition in Rapid City back in February. You can tune in and watch the highlights from the championships on Saturday. That's on Friday, at 3:30 p.m. Central Time, 2:30 Mountain. The South Dakota High School Gymnastics Championships on SDPB TV. And actually, that will be Saturday, and as well as today, I believe, at 3:30.
Yep, that will be Saturday. And just a quick correction. And that's not your fault, it was written down wrong. Gymnastics championships this year were in Aberdeen at Aberdeen Central High School. And that will air on SDPB1. That's on Saturday at about 3:30 after the fifth place game at the girls' AA basketball tournament, which is on SDPB1 right now. Get you an update here in a moment as the free throw is no good. And the rebound is going to be out of bounds. And it's going to go to Sully Buttes. Coach Malloy not happy at all. Chargers get another chance here. Wenches gets it in. And that's Raquel Wenches on the pass from sister Remy Wenches. And now it's an 11-point lead for Sully Buttes.
Largest lead of the day for Sully Buttes, and the Raiders need to answer here with 2 minutes left to go. Try to get it back into single digits before halftime.
They'll lob it down low. Barta backs in off the window, got it. Kalia Barta, her first 2 points of the game. Under 2 minutes to go. The lead is 9 for the Chargers as they work on offense. Raiders staying in that 2-3 zone. Remy Wenches looks around, calls out a play. Barta will pressure. They go cross court. Now here's Stahl, lobs it down low. Fade away, no good, but Stahl another offensive rebound, and she's going to be fouled again. Sully Buttes has just been effective on the offensive glass, and Vanessa Reichen has just picked up her third personal foul for the Raiders.
And again, Gable Volin worked on that during their shoot-around yesterday, but so far, their efforts have been ineffective against what Sully Bukes is doing inside. They're crashing the boards. They're boxing out ahead of the Raiders' defenders and finding ways to get those offensive rebounds, second-chance points. That's just the aggressiveness and really the size advantage that Sully Bukes brings to this tournament.
Jenny Clark will replace Vanessa Reichen. Clark out there with two fouls. Minute 32 left. The lead is 10. Still at 10, but there's another rebound for the Chargers, Remy Winches.
They're missing their free throws. The Raiders just aren't finding a way to get the rebounds. If they can clean off the glass, they'd be right in this game. And still are, for that matter.
Ball's out of bounds off of a Raider. I think that was Hirsch, went off her knee. Out of bounds to Sully Bukes. Coach Malloy pleading with his team to get a defensive rebound. You cannot give Sully Bukes too many opportunities. Nelson, three. In and out, rebound tapped along the baseline. It's gonna go to the Raiders. You look up Mark Sefner, the head coach for the Sully Bukes Chargers.
And now you're gonna get some more full court pressure here from Sully Bukes to try to keep the clamp on the Raiders here. They have three defenders in the backcourt, two of them now backing away. But this is a team really trying to put the pedal to the metal here now over the last minute and 10 seconds.
Pass outside, Nelson. Can't get a shot away with Remy Winches right in front of her. They'll pass around to Clark. She'll drive, lob it up. No good, draws the foul. Two free throws coming up, and that's gonna be on Raquel Winches. That is her second.
Jenny Clark was the third leading scorer for this team during the regular season, averaging just over 11 and a half points a game. You can tell she uses her speed and her athleticism to try to kind of water bug her way inside the lane, try to find those open seams. If nothing else, she's getting to the free throw line because she's drawing contact. Missed that last one, but she's been pretty consistent from the line overall today as she misses her second here.
Well, that one bounced over the backboard, took that high bounce off the back part of the iron. With under a minute to go here, Sully Bukes up by 10. Don't know if they'll play for the final shot necessarily. Kind of not their style. They're an up and down the court kind of team. Looks like they're going to run the normal offense. Nelson handles. The Winches sisters out on the perimeter.
There's about 20 seconds off the clock, so it appears that they might try to dwindle this one down as close as they can get to the end of the quarter here. Now down to 25 seconds remaining. They're just content passing it around the perimeter and try to get that last shot inside.
Yep, Raiders are really packing the paint defensively, and Sully Bukes says, okay, we'll just back it out. I thought they'd run the normal offense, but they're being very patient. They'll play for the final shot. 10 seconds and counting. Nelson handles. Remy Winches, open, three, no good. Backside rebound, pulled down by Clark. She lost it out of bounds, but they say, oh, it went off the knee of Clark. And a chance with 1.3 seconds left for Sully Bukes.
Clark looking frustrated. She thought she was fouled as she came down with the rebound. No call from the officials, and now Sully Bukes with the last chance here at the quarter.
Raquel Winches, no good, and we're done with one half of basketball. 27-17 in favor of the Sully Bukes Chargers over the Raiders of Gayville Volin. We'll take a break, come back with more. This is the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Welcome back to the Huron Arena. Steve Toom, J.J. Hartigan here. Halftime of our first game of the day, the first of four here today on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. It's Sully Bukes leading Gayville Volin 27-17. Give you a quick update from the AA tournament. There at halftime, Sioux Falls, Washington has jumped out to a 31-21 lead over Harrisburg.
And, of course, we'll have the boys' state tournament coming up next week on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The South Dakota State High School Boys Championships will be live right here on SDPB-TV. You can find Class A on SDPB-1, Class B will be on SDPB-2, and Class AA will be on SDPB-3. Steve Toom will be out there for sure. I'm hoping I can be out there. We're still waiting to see what will happen with SDSU women's basketball, but hopefully we'll be coming from the Mount Rushmore area out there in Rapid City. And of course, all the coverage of high school championships are available online at sdpb.org.
And make sure you tell your friends and your relatives about the online coverage, especially if they live out of state, or maybe they're stationed in the military overseas, or maybe their work has taken them overseas, maybe they're traveling. They can keep up with all the action at sdpb.org. And you can also stream it on your tablet, on your smartphone. Got many ways that you can keep up on all the action from all the tournaments, not just this week, but next week as well. Of course, the A tournament for girls, they haven't started yet. They're out in Spearfish, and so they'll be getting started here in just a little bit. We thank you for tuning in this week for South Dakota Public Broadcasting's coverage. This is the first of four games today. We'll have all the games on television here from all of the tournaments. Right now, we've got the Bridgewater Emory Husky Band. They're the band of the day here at the Class B tournament. They've been doing a fantastic job here. Why don't we listen to it for just a couple of moments? Back with more from the Class B tournament in just a moment. This is SDPB 3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
We are back at the Huron Arena. Halftime here, 27-17. Quick check of stats. Individual scoring for Sully Buttes. It's Remy Wenches leading the way with 9. 8 for Carly Stahl. 4 for Kayla Nelson. Also 4 for Raquel Wenches. And 2 points for Chloe Lamb. That's how the Chargers stack up here in the first half. 4 players have scored for the Raiders, led by Jenny Clark with 8. Rachel Haas with 4. Laura Nelson with 3. And Kalia Bardo with 2 points. Vanessa Reichen, 3 fouls yet to score in the game, but her presence on the court is a big, big factor, especially on the defensive end. We're going to take one more break, then we'll come back with the third quarter of basketball. This is the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB 3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Hey, it's me again, Ed, your local Touchstone Energy expert. Did you know we already generate enough energy from the wind to dry over 1 million loads of laundry? That water is powering hundreds of thousands of homes. And even methane gas from this gal is turned into renewable energy. Find out how at StopEnergyLeaks.com. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives. We're your energy experts.
The great thing about snowboarding is the adventure. All day long, you're finding different ways of doing different things, and it's never the same. I don't mind snowboarding alone, but if you've got your friends up there on the mountain and you guys can all cruise down together, it's a really, really fun time. Snowboarding has been really fun and really rewarding for me, and I want it to be fun and rewarding for my customers as well. I'm Lindsay McKinstry, and I'm one of the snowboard experts at Shields.
Getting ready for the third quarter of action here at the Huron Civic Arena, the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament here on SDPB 3. Steve Toome and J.J. Hardigan here. Some more stats here. Rebounding, the edge to Sully Buttes at 18-13, but 10 offensive rebounds for Sully Buttes. Really, that's the difference in the game.
Really, that is the big difference in the game. And if you take a look at the inside numbers stat-wise, Sully Buttes, 10 of 26 from the floor, only shooting 38%. It's not like they're having an outstanding day shooting. They've just taken 10 more shots than Gayville Volin is, and they've made 5 more. So really, if you can get Gayville Volin more involved offensively, get a few more high percentage shots instead of all those jumpers between the free throw line and the arc, they might have a chance to get back in this game. But they need to come out with some confidence here to start this second half, or else this deficit could get a little worse. Right now, just a 10-point game. They're very much in it here going into the second half.
key for the Raiders, Vanessa Ryken. Three fouls, two each on Rachel Haas and on Jenny Clark as well. The only charger with two fouls, or actually a couple of them, are Chloe Lamb and Raquel Winches. And it will be the Raiders to start the third period with the basketball. And they'll get it into Laura Nelson. Talking with Mr. Rice, the principal over at Gayville Volin School. A lot of these young ladies involved in many different sports, many of them involved in the school play. A long three on the way, it's an air ball out of bounds. Misfired there by Barda. Vanessa Ryken mentioned 4 years All-State Honors Choir. Also the student council president is Vanessa Ryken.
Pretty impressive young lady.
And she and I believe it, one of the other students, they sing the national anthem for all the home games being performed at the football championships. They've been doing that for a number of years. Sully Butte's on offense. Yeah, Ryken and Kalia Barda do that for the Raiders. Barda, multi-sport athlete as well. Here's a drive, and it's up and good. And that is Chloe Lamb with 4 points in the game.
And Sully Butte's just looked calm, composed. They knew what they wanted to do offensively. They took their time. They got the shot they wanted. Really made it look easy there against the Raider defense.
With all the big games Sully Butte's has played over the years, it's really tough to rattle this team. There's a shot up and no good. The rebound pulled down by Clark. Her putback, no good. She follows her shot out to the corner. Nelson brings it down there for the Chargers. Kayla Nelson, that is.
Matt Malloy, the head coach of the Raiders, a moment ago telling his players, go up strong. If you go in with confidence on those high percentage shots, you've got a pretty good chance of making them. And a mistake there on the defensive end now as well kind of digs them deeper in this hole.
And that's going to be Rachel Haas picking up her third foul on the drive by Remy Winches. Winches to the line, one of three on the day. First foul the second half for either team. Quickly Viola Ishmael to the scorer's table. 10 points now for Remy Winches. Haas is going to check out, and the 5'7 sophomore Ishmael in. The lead 13 at the moment. You get a look at Remy Winches, a 5'9 senior. Got them both, give her 11. And now a little bit of pressure. That'll be Nelson bringing it up court. Nelson works against Chloe Lamb, goes to the corner. Drive, shut off, pass, tapped out of bounds by Stahl. It will stay with Gayville Volin. Sully Butte's team so very versatile. They have height and speed. They can score inside. They can score from the perimeter. Outside, Ishmael will give it away to Barda. Back to Ishmael, wants the drive. Shut off there by Deidre Lamb, and then a travel. Turnover, Gayville Volin. A little bit of an unforced error there for the Raiders. 6 minutes to go, and a 14-point lead for the number one seed, Sully Butte's Chargers. Town that is well known for basketball, both boys and girls. Here's Stahl, and she got it. Shot off the window, give her 10 points on the day, and the lead is now ballooned to 16 for Sully Buttes. Ishmael on the perimeter, gives way to Nelson. Looks for Barda, can't get the shot off from the right wing. And the Raiders will reset. Nelson thought about the three. Down low, it's tipped away, but right back to the Raiders. Megan Hirsch, who kind of lost her footing. Clark on the drive, and she gets clobbered driving down the lane. Got tripped up, hit the deck hard. That foul will be on Kayla Nelson. That is her second, but this was in the act of shooting, and that sends Jenny Clark back to the line, 8 points on the day.
She had a little attitude getting up off the floor. They're almost trying to make a statement saying that she's not going to take this. what Sully Butts has been offering right now. Gets to the free throw line, makes a free throw, trying to be a leader out there on the floor for her team.
Ryken in, Ishmael out for Gayville Volin. Ryken out there with three fouls. And that one's going to fall eventually. 10 points for Clark. That breaks up a big run there by Sully Butts. We're on a 6-0 run. Pass down low. Stall maneuvers short. Tip to the outside. Controlled by the Chargers. They'll reset. Nelson, Kayla Nelson, that is. Skip pass over. Chloe Lamb steps inside. A Ryken counted and the foul. What a move there by Chloe Lamb. And that's going to be the fourth foul on Vanessa Ryken. And she'll have to check out. Big loss there. Ryken just came back in. Now she has to go to the bench with four fouls. That's a big loss there for Gayville Volin. Chloe Lamb at the free throw line. And she got it. Raiders play it in. Tipped out of bounds. It will stay with Gayville Volin. Timeout on the court. We'll take a break. You're watching the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We're back at the Huron Arena, third quarter. Our first game of the day, Class B Girls Basketball Tournament. Sully Butts leads Gayville Volin 36-19. Raiders play it in against the full court pressure. But Barta gets it into the front court without too much difficulty. Raiders down by 17. They'll fire a three. Too strong. Rebound to the Raiders. Jump ball. Possession arrow. We'll go to Sully Butts. And a little confusion here. Raiders thought they had it. Nope, it's Sully Butts' ball. They'll get Olivia Roush and Raquel Winches into the game. Deidre Lamb goes to the bench. And so will Kayla Nelson. Chloe Lamb will bring it up, gives way to Stahl. Now they'll lob it down low. Turnaround, Remy Winches in the paint. Nice finish. She's got 13. And the lead is 19 points. Here's the drive. Barta puts it up. No good. Draws the foul for the Raiders. Two shots coming up at the charity stripe for Kalia Barta. That foul will be on Chloe Lamb, and that is her third. Barta makes the first.
Boy, if Gayville Volin isn't making their free throws here, this could be a much different game. They're 7 of 9, now make it 7 of 10 from the free throw line today. But that's really what's kept them in it here. Sully Butts has missed a ton of free throws already today. In fact, they've missed 8 free throws. While Gayville Volin has missed just the 3 here this evening, but still, it's an 18-point deficit here right now for those Raiders.
Ball will stay with Sully Butts after it was tapped out of bounds. And it will be Raquel Winches to trigger it for Sully Butts. Gets it into Chloe Lamb. And she's going to get some free throws coming up as she was fouled. 3 free throws coming up. And that foul will be on Megan Hirsch. Cardinal sin there. He can't foul the jump shooter beyond the arc. Chloe Lamb's going to go and the free throw line for 3 attempts as she was fouled on a 3-point shot with 3:44 left. And her team up by 18. She's 1 of 1 on the day. Nothing but nylon there. She has 8 points currently. But it takes her time at the line. Misfires on that one. Sub in. Viola Ishmael will check in. She'll replace Laura Nelson. Sub coming in here for Sully Buttes if this free throw is good. And it is. That'll be Deidre Lamb checking in, the 5'9 sophomore. She'll replace Chloe Lamb.
And again, more full court pressure coming from Sully Buttes. As the Raiders try to find a way to get back into this game here with 3:40 left to go in the third. And they're going to get Jenny Clark. She pushed a little too much with that right forearm this time, trying to create separation between her and the defender. Tough play there. She was just trying to get into that right corner, try to set up an offensive play. Maybe some frustration starting to mount for these Raiders here in this second half.
And that's the third foul on Clark. Some of the Raiders racking up the fouls. Riken's already on the bench with four. They're trying to post up Deidre Lamb. Works against Ishmael. Got that one. That is the first points of the day for Deidre Lamb as the 5'9 sophomore was posted up on Ishmael at 5'7.
Yeah, she was 0 for 4 on the day prior to that bucket. Now 1 of 5 getting her first points in the state tournament. Maybe a little weight off of her shoulders as the timeout's called by Matt Malloy and the Raiders.
3:11 left, 42-20, Sully Buttes on top. Quick update from the AA tournament, Sioux Falls, Washington. About 2.5 minutes left to go in the third period. Lee Terrisburg, 31-24.
If you were a music act in the 1960s, there was one place that you yearned to perform. That's on the Ed Sullivan Show. Tonight after basketball on SDPB 1 TV, see some great performances from some rock and roll legends such as the Beatles, the Rolling Stones, the Doors, the Mamas and the Papas, the Supremes, and more. Ed Sullivan's Rock and Roll Classics, followed by basketball tonight on SDPB 1.
Rebounding stats, 23-14, the edge for Sully Buttes. Sully Buttes with 11 offensive rebounds in this game. That really has been the difference. Turnovers, also a big factor in this game. 9-3, Gayville Volin with more turnovers. 6 assists as a team for Sully Buttes, 3 for Gayville Volin. 4 steals for the Chargers, just 2 for Gayville Volin.
Getting back to the rebounding column, they're plus 9 overall today, and 8 of those are on the offensive glass for Sully Buttes. So it has been an impressive performance inside. They're getting second chance opportunities, 13 points off the second chance alone today.
Clark has her shot deflected out of bounds as she drove down the lane. It'll stay with Gayville Volin.
Clark's doing everything she can to try to keep her team in the game. She's got 10 points on today, trying to create something offensively. But it has been a frustrating afternoon overall for the Raiders.
There's a drive by Clark. She'll lob it up. Players hit the deck, no whistle. And the ball comes down to the hands of Sully Buttes. Wenches passes underneath, a finish there by Raquel Wenches on the pass from Remy Wenches. Wonder how many times they practice that in the backyard.
They could probably do it in their sleep at this point.
Yeah. They're both of them incredibly good players. Pass inside for Hirsch, tipped away, stolen by Stahl. Coach Malloy directing his team, get back on defense. Wenches comes up, the jumper, no good. Rebound loose and picked out by Rausch. And Sully Buttes with another offensive rebound. Here's a drive by Raquel Wenches, and she's going to be hacked. Two free throws coming up for Sully Buttes.
Sully Buttes acting like a team that's obviously been to the state tournament before. They were the fourth place team a season ago with Warner winning the championship. And I have a feeling that Sully Buttes is hoping to maybe move up in the rankings a little bit this season and see if they can't knock off Warner. And the way they've been playing today, they're looking like they might be one of the more confident teams coming into this tournament.
Number one seed, number one in the final poll. Clark and Haas check out. Haas picked up the foul. That's her fourth. Into the game is Treya Hubbard, number 43. First time today for Gayville Volin. Free throw on the way, and it's nothing but net. And the lead up to 46-20. 19-3, the scoring advantage in this quarter so far for Sully Buttes. 2 minutes and counting. Barta drives. And she'll get some free throws. Had a lane to the bucket. Good screen up top by Hubbard. And that foul will be on Olivia Rausch. The 5'6 sophomore picks up her first. Barta at the line, one of two, 3 points on the day. That one eventually goes in. Jerrica Menninger, number 15, into the game now for Sully Buttes. She'll replace Remy Wenches. Barta now has five. With the Raquel Wenches handling the basketball. Menninger on the perimeter. Only one Wenches on the court at the moment. That's Raquel, number 21. Traveling, called on Roush. Turnover, Sully Buttes. No pressure this time for the Chargers. Warner and Lemon, the matchup coming after the conclusion of this game. That'll be our second game of the afternoon session. Nelson feeds way to Ishmael. No shot forward there on the right side. Barta has to give way to Ishmael. Travel. Turnover, Raiders. A little indecision there for Ishmael, the 5'7 sophomore. Sully Buttes hits it with Wenches. Round to Roush. Oh, through the hands of Aaron Foth. Here comes Ishmael. She lost the handle. Barta tries to pick it up. Eventually she does. She'll settle things down for the Raiders. Fires the long J. Got it. That's a two.
And they need Barta to get going. She was their leading scorer during the regular season. 12 and a half points a game this season. Five rebounds. Kind of has been pretty quiet here so far today.
She does have 5 points in this period, but her team's still down by 18. 40 seconds and counting. Roush handles up top for the Chargers. Plays catch there with Wenches. Over to Menninger. Deidre Lamb in the corner. Looking inside, Foth not open. High post. Here comes Raquel Wenches. Nifty jumper there. And she's in double figures with 10. Coming off the bench, she averages 9. Barta on the drive, gives way to Ishmael in the corner, puts it up in the paint, too strong, Hubbard, and she's gonna be fouled, and she'll get free throws with 4 seconds on the clock. And that foul will be on Raquel Wenches. That is her third. Team's fourth. Hubbard at the line. Misfires. 6'1 freshman, Treya Hubbard. Short, rebound, Hubbard puts it up, no good. And then she got called for traveling. She did follow the shot, gotta give her credit for that. Just got a little too excited once she collected the ball in traffic. We're done with three periods of play, 48-24. Sully Buttes leads Gayville Volin. This is the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Back at the Huron Civic Arena, fourth quarter action, first game of the day. Quarterfinal round, Class B Tournament. Sully Buttes and Gayville Volin. Raiders start the period with the basketball. They're down by a bunch and they turn it over. 48-24 is our score. Sully Buttes, Remy Wenches. Misfires on a couple of shots and a travel call there.
Some of the Boo Birds here inside the Huron Arena were hoping for a travel call on that spin move initially, but they get the call there the second time as she went to the floor. Maybe some frustration on the side of Gayville Volin here as we enter the fourth quarter, but still as they went into the huddle there during the timeout, head coach Matt Malloy said that they played a much better third quarter than he saw in the first half, so at least some positives coming out of it here for the Raiders in this second half.
Haas misfires on the shot. Going back the other way, Sully Buttes. Turnaround off the window, no good for Deidre Lamb, and we've got a rebounding foul. And that is going to be on Stahl, and that's her first. 7:16 left to go in regulation. Chargers have doubled up the Raiders. A tournament just getting underway out in Spearfish as Haas in and out on the three. Had a good look and winches the rebound. Reichen back into the game for the Raiders. She's been plagued by foul trouble all day. Number 12 for Gayville Volin has four fouls, as does Rachel Haas, number 11. Chloe Lamb hands off to Remy Winches. Sully Butte so very patient, waiting for their opportunities. They find the backdoor cutter, no good. And second opportunity there for Chloe Lamb, not good, but she draws the contact. Let's see who collects that foul. And that is going to be Rachel Haas, and her day is done. She will exit the game with 4 points. Megan Hirsch will check in to replace her. So Rachel Haas, the 5'7 senior, checks out with five fouls, six team fouls. And that will send Chloe Lamb to the line, 3 of 4 on the game. Makes that one. That puts her into double figures with 10 points. The thing about Sully Buttes, they have such balance. They don't rely on one player. They just come at you in waves. Got them both. Give her 11 on the day. The lead is 50 to 24 as Clark drives, lost the handle, bottled up along the baseline, ball's loose, somehow got it away, but Chloe Lamb intercepts it. Fast break opportunity. Winches running past the finish. Stall good. She's got a dozen on the day. That shows you how effective Sully Buttes can be in the open court. Drive by Bardick, kick to the corner. Nelson can't get it shot away. Clark thought about it. Looking to drive, lobs it up and draws a foul and two free throws. Jenny Clark's been pretty fearless driving into the paint today against this very formidable Charger defense. Carly Stahl, foul number two. Six-team foul. Clark back at the line. She's 10 points on the day. Make it 11.
Quick update while we can. They are underway now in the Class A tournament. Garrettson and St. Thomas More. And right now it's St. Thomas More up 4-0 from that AA tournament in Brookings. It's a good one right now with Sioux Falls Washington in the fourth quarter, leading Harrisburg by 8, 38-30.
Ishmael in, Clark out for the Raiders. Sully Buttes passes around the perimeter. Here's a drive through the hands of Stahl. She'll have to improvise. Counted in the foul. Stahl lost the handle and then just took it to the bucket and drew the foul on Ishmael. That's her first. 14 points now for Stahl. Make it 15. Hubbard in. She'll replace Reichen. A little bit of pressure now. And it backs away. Sparta brings it up, looking to drive. Sully Buttes been pretty much man-to-man most of the game. That's their style. Ishmael gives it away there to Nelson. Back to Ishmael, looking to drive, puts it up, has a block, tipped, loose, on the perimeter. Gabriel Volin ends up with it. They'll lob it outside. Barta brings it away. Here's Nelson, the jumper, it's blocked. Ball's loose in the corner, picked up by Chloe Lamb. Remy Winches had the block there. Sully Buttes on offense with Kayla Nelson. Skip pass over to Winches, drives. Spots Stahl in the paint, put it up, no good foul. Two free throws coming up for Carly Stahl again. And that foul will be on Megan Hirsch, and that is her third. Stahl back to the line. Been there a lot today. Makes the first. 4:52 left, 30-point edge, Sully Buttes. That one's no good. But the rebound fought for, jump ball. Timeout on the court. We'll take a break. This is the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3 South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the Huron Arena. Fourth quarter action here. Quick shot up, no good by Raquel Winches, and Stahl with another rebound, and she's going to be fouled, and I think Vanessa Reichen has just fouled out of the game as she runs back to the bench. And Vanessa Reichen, one of the leaders, didn't score today, but her leadership will be missed here for the final 4:49. Oh, no, they didn't give it to Reichen. They gave it to Hubbard. So Reichen's still in the game. Hubbard gets her first foul. I thought Reichen fouled out the way she ran back to the bench, like, oh, yeah, it's on me. I know it. I'm out.
You're not the only one. Head coach Matt Malloy and Reichen herself all thought that that was her fifth. They were getting ready to bring in a sub for a fifth foul, and once they realized it wasn't on her, they said, well, we'll give you a little break here to start the fourth quarter anyways.
Free throws missed. Danila Jensen, 5'7 sophomore, now into the game for the Raiders. Ishmael in the corner, drives. Hirsch, the free throw line jumper, it's short. Hubbard, rebound, put back, block, out of bounds. Nice block by Stahl. It'll stay with the Raiders. And the Raiders will trigger in. They get it into Hirsch. Nielsen with the ball, or Jensen rather, and the turnover for the Raiders. Quickly, Reichen going to get back to the scorer's table. She'll check in and she'll replace Jensen. Sully Buttes will have Chloe Lamb bringing it up the court. Sully Buttes, their passes are so crisp, so quick. Missed shot there by Winches. Goes out of bounds off of a Raider. It'll stay with Sully Buttes. Their execution on offense. It's just fun to watch if you're a basketball fan.
Yeah, right now four players on the floor in double figures. Only one other player not in double figures, and that's the shooter right there. She's got 4 points down today, missed one. But even so, this is a very balanced attack coming from this Sully Buttes school.
Rebound comes down to the Raiders, and then you bring in a player like Raquel Winches, who averages 9 coming off the bench. That's even more balanced. This Sully Buttes team, there's a reason why they're the number one seed, and they were number one in the final poll.
And Class B is loaded with talent, so to be able to be the number one seed at this level of high school basketball with all these teams competing day in and day out, it's really a testament to how good this program has been this season.
Winches finishes. And there are a lot of players in Class B that are going on to play college basketball and volleyball and track and field. Just because you're from a small town doesn't mean you can't play, because we're going to see a lot of young ladies here at this tournament. We're going to have a foul called on Kayla Nelson. There's a lot of young ladies you're going to see compete at the next level, some in basketball, some in volleyball, as some reserves coming in. Hirsch's going to check out. Some reserves in here also for Sully Buttes.
Again, a reminder, the winner of this game will not play again until Friday night at 6 p.m. They'll play the winner of our next game coming up here today at 1:45. That's number 4, Warner, taking on number 5, Lemon. As the free throw's made.
And Viola Ishmael into the scoring column. And that's the advantage of being the number one seed, because if you win, you essentially get a day and a half off. In and out. Rebound pulled down there by Raquel Winches. Some teams maybe not used to playing in the afternoon, but with Sully Buttes, with all the tournaments and the classics that they play at all times of the day throughout the season. A nice drive and the finish there by Chloe Lamb. Some teams, you know, they're not used to playing in the early afternoon. But Sully Buttes with their tough schedule. Nelson Has to give it outside to Ryken. Here's Nelson with the three. It's short. The rebound tipped around and controlled by Chloe Lamb. The Sully Buttes team, they're tested. They play tough competition. As there's a steal by Ryken. Ryken maneuvers up court. One player to beat. Stripped away by Nelson. Oh, what a play by Kayla Nelson. Number one for Sully Buttes. Looked like Ryken was going to get a layup. She did a good job. Ryken weaving through traffic, but couldn't get past the last player, Kayla Nelson. Backdoor cut. Roush puts it up and in. Counted and the foul. Olivia Roush into the scoring column. And that foul, I believe, is going to be on Hubbard. And nope, check that. That is going to be on Addison Bertrand, who just checked into the game. That's her first. Probably see some reserves coming in here in the final 2:12 as Roush to the line. Averages a point and a rebound a game. Just fires on the free throw, and pulling it down is Bertrand.
We got to give this Gayville Volin team a lot of credit here. They've come out and obviously had a tough matchup on day one, playing the number one seed and arguably one of the best teams in the entire state of South Dakota. But even so, they've come out. They haven't given up when they've gotten down, and they're fighting until the bitter end here. You can see players flying all over the floor trying to stay in this game. And you got to give a lot of credit to their first-year head coach, Matt Malloy. He's bringing a kind of a new philosophy to the program, and this is the first time in a long time that this team even got to a regional championship game. I believe 1980 was the last time they went, and for them to get to the state tournament this year, it's pretty impressive.
Minute 48 and counting, 62-27, Sully Buttes on top. So they've got some new players into the game. Menninger into the game. There's a new player, that's Mindy Ravnus. Roush on the drive, kicks it outside, winches the jumper, in and out, the rebound to Ishmael.
One thing we can say about Gabriel Volin here in the second half is they've been rebounding much better. They haven't been getting beat quite as much on the defensive end there. Sully Buttes with not even close to as many offensive rebounds this half as they had in the first half there. But the big problem for Gayville Volin, they've only made one field goal here in the second half. They had five total makes as a team in the first half. Right now they're 6 of 31, shooting 19%. They've had good looks. It just hasn't fallen their way here this afternoon.
4 points now on the day for Nelson. Reserve in, Rachel Guthmiller. She'll replace Winches. Nelson had a three-pointer early on. That's her first point since the first quarter. Got them both, Laura Nelson. And a sub in, that's Grace Dangle, number 23 in. She'll replace Nelson for Gayville Volin. Aaron Foth into the game. As Ravnus brings it up court. We'll get a look at the reserve players here. For the final minute 10. There's a shot on the way, no good. Rebound pulled down by the Raiders, nearly stolen by Roush. Ishmael will handle. She'll drive down the lane and she'll draw the blocking foul. Roush hit the deck and she'll collect her third foul. So a lot of the sophomores and freshmen out there for both teams. And Ishmael to the line, one of two on the day. And she's got 2 points now.
And good luck, Steve. We got a line change coming in here for Sully Buttes. A lot of their reserves coming in now. We'll try to get their names to you guys as quickly as we can.
Kristen Seek in. Audrey Johnson is in for Sully Buttes. We'll try to pick them up as we go. Also, Bailey Bradford into the game. Ishmael connects. I'm kind of used to this. I've done Briar Cliff basketball the last couple of years on radio, and Coach Mike Power does this about 10 times a game, so I'm used to seeing four or five players come in.
Hannah Weimheiner is in the game as well for Sully Buttes.
Here's a shot on the way, and it's good, and it's a three. That's Audrey Johnson with the bucket for Sully Buttes. Always like to see those reserve players get into the scoring column. Here's a shot on the way. It's no good. It's tipped once, twice into the corner, picked up there by Bradford. Here comes Johnson up court with the ball. They get it into the paint. Outside, tipped once, twice, stolen away by the Raiders. 10 seconds left. Let's see if the Raiders can get a shot here. It's on the way. It's going to be short. Rebound loose to Sully Buttes, and that's how this game will end. 65-31. Sully Buttes advances to semifinal night with the win over Gayville Volin. We'll take a break and come back with more. This is the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
We're back in Huron at the Civic Arena. Game number one in the books, Sully Buttes over Gayville Volin, 65-31. This game was relatively close at halftime at 27-17. But a big third quarter surge by Sully Buttes. Gayville Volin kind of got going late in that third quarter, but they were just down by too many points at that time, JJ.
Yeah, Sully Buttes shot 46% on the day. The offense was obviously there. Their bench outscored Gayville Volin 15-3, but the second chance opportunities in the first half there were absolutely huge for Sully Buttes. They ended up with 17 second chance points compared to just the 1 second chance point from Gayville Volin today, and 16 points off of turnovers today also hurt the Raiders as they were unable to really secure the basketball, and it was really a tough matchup from the very beginning there. You just feel bad for them, obviously, to have to get that 1-8 seed right away, but they still have 2 games and could still finish with a nice tournament when it's all said and done if they're able to rebound tomorrow.
Rebounding for Sully Buttes, they out-rebounded the Raiders 38-26, 18 offensive rebounds on the day for Sully Buttes. Sully Buttes had 4 players in double figures, led by Carly Stahl with 16, 15 for Remy Winches, 13 for Chloe Lamb, 10 for Raquel Winches. Then 4 points for Kayla Nelson, 3 for Audrey Johnson, 2 for Deidre Lamb. That's how the scoring ends up today. Also 2 for Olivia Roush for Sully Buttes. Meanwhile, Gayville Volin was led by Jenny Clark. She had 12 points. She was the only Raider to get into double figures. 7 for Kalia Barda, 5 for Laura Nelson, 4 for Rachel Haas, and 3 for Viola Ishmael. And only 5 players on the day scored for Gayville Volin. They were just 6 of 33 from the floor for 18%. Meanwhile, Sully Buttes 23 of 50. That's good for 46%. Free throws, 9 of 16 for Sully Buttes on the day. Or check that they were 16 of 29, free throws on the day, 3 of 9 from beyond the arc. Free throws, 17 of 23 on the day for Gayville Volin. So rebounding and the turnovers, that was really the key stats, JJ.
Yeah, and as we take a look around the rest of the state here today in the first round of action, the AA game has just gone final. Sioux Falls Washington uses a 12-5 run to end the game, and they pick up the 50-35 win over Harrisburg, so they move on to the semifinals. And in the Class A tournament, which got underway just a short while ago, in fact, they are just now in the second quarter, it's St. Thomas More 27-4 over Garrison. St. Thomas More scored 26 first quarter points to get out to the early lead. That's impressive.
We'll take a timeout, come back with more. This is the Class B Girls State Basketball Tournament on SDPB3, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.